بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today إن شاء الله we'll talk about molecular pathogenesis of hematological malignancies. My name is Dr. Marwa Ibrahim Khidr. I am lecturer of medical biochemistry and molecular biology at Alexandria Faculty of Medicine and the clinical pathology specialist at Faculty of Medicine for Girls at Azhar University. Today إن شاء الله we'll talk about some important definitions regarding the molecular mechanisms of hematological malignancies and mutations, key genes controlling the cell cycle and the molecular mechanisms of hematological malignancies. Let's start with some important definitions. What is malignancy? Group of diseases characterized by abnormal uncontrolled growth that arise from loss of control upon the cell cycle. The hematological and lymphoid malignancies, they are cancers that begin in blood-forming tissues such as the bone marrow or in the lymphoid organs. The genome is the organism's complete set of DNA, and the ploidy is the number of complete sets of chromosomes in a cell. Humans are diploid organisms carrying two complete sets of chromosomes, one set of 23 chromosomes from their father and one set of 23 chromosomes from their mothers. So all of us have the diploid number of chromosomes. Each one chromosome has another copy, okay? So when the cell is of diploid number, so it's called 2N. While if one copy of a chromosome is not present, this is called a haploid or single N. And when it is copied or have a third copy, this is called the triploid. So the monoploid or haploid number is the number of chromosomes found in a single complete set of chromosomes or the total number of chromosomes found in a gamete. So we have somatic cells and gametes. The somatic cells have the diploid number of chromosomes while the gametes have the haploid number of chromosomes. Euploid cell is the cell with any number of complete chromosomal sets. The monosomy is the lack of one copy of one chromosome like that. This is a monosomy, chromosome number 16. And the trisomy is the presence of three copies of the same chromosome. Aneuploidy is the presence of abnormal number of chromosomes found in a cell. Also, we have an important definition of epigenetics, which is the external modification of DNA that turns genes on and off through alteration of the rates of transcription without alteration of the nucleotide sequence. So this is an important definition to differentiate epigenetics from mutations. Mutations have an alteration in the nucleotide sequence, while epigenetics is an external modification of DNA that turns the gene on and off through methylation or histone modifications. The clonal evolution of cancer is a stepwise acquisition of mutation in one cell and its progeny, leading to the development of a cancer. Okay, let's take an idea about mutations. Mutations are heritable alterations of the nucleotide sequence in a given region of the gene. Normally, these alterations are recognized during the checkpoints of the cell cycle, leading to cell cycle arrest and repair of these alterations. Otherwise, cells will be committed into the pathway of apoptosis if the alteration is irreparable. So this is the normal fate of mutations that occur in any stage of the cell cycle. It will get repaired, and if it's not repaired, the cell will go into apoptosis, which is a programmed cell death. But pathologically, these alterations escape the checkpoint and are transmitted to the cell progeny to become a fixed part of the genome of the affected cells and their progeny. The site of mutations may be within the coding sequence, which may or may not change the amino acid sequence, or within the non-coding sequence. And this may be at the splice junction of mutation, which leading to production of new splice site, or mutation in the enhancer or the promoter, leading to decrease of the rate of synthesis of protein. These are the sites of mutation, whether in the coding sequence or in the non-coding sequence. The mechanisms of mutation may be one of two. Whether point mutation, and this represents 70% of genetic diseases, and from the name, there is an exchange in one point, exchange of a single nucleotide for another, which may be silent mutation and leading to coding for the same amino acid of the protein, or it may be a missense mutation, which code for a different amino acid, and this will lead to a pathology or not. Or a nonsense mutation, which code for a stop codon and can truncate the protein, so there will be a defective protein. Or a new sense mutation, which converts a stop codon to a coding sequence producing an elongated protein chain. The second mechanism of mutation is the indels, or deletion or insertion. Indels, insertion or deletion. The deletion is removal of one or more nucleotides, which may be deletion without a frame shift in the coding sequence. Frame shift means three codons. You know that the sequence of gene expression is converting the gene into, or transcription of a gene into messenger RNA. This messenger RNA will be converted or expressed into a protein or translated into protein. The messenger RNA carries a message in the form of codons. What is the codons? A set of three nucleotides. These sets nucleotides is translated into amino acid. Each three nucleotides is called the codon, translated into one amino acid. The codon is called frame shift. Okay, so deletion without a frame shift in the coding sequence lead to deletion of three nucleotides or multiples of three. Deletion with frame shift in the coding sequence lead to the deletion of a number of nucleotides that is not divisible by three, or deletion of one or more gene. This is a picture which represents deletion of one nucleotide, okay? Deletion of one nucleotide will lead to frame shift. Why? Because these three nucleotides, which represent one codon, these three will be translated normally, then the next three will not be translated normally because they were C, T, G. When T is deleted, okay, the codon will be CGC, which translated into another amino acid. The mechanisms of insertion include addition of one or more nucleotides, which may be insertion without a frame shift or insertion with a frame shift in the coding sequence. This is the DNA, or the normal DNA sequence. Okay, this is the normal DNA sequence. Each three nucleotides represent one codon, like that, which when translated, it will be translated into this amino acid sequence. One codon, one amino acid. CAG codes for glutamine amino acid. CCC code for proline amino acid, and so on. When there is an insertion mutation, one nucleotide is inserted like that, there will be a frame shift because the CCC will be converted into TCC, which code for abnormal amino acid, which is called serine instead of proline like that. Also, we have insertion mutation, which do not cause frame shift like that. Insertion of a whole codon like that, TTT, will lead to amino acid insertion, complete amino acid insertion between glutamine and the proline, like that. I hope it is easy. I think I know that this part is so complicated. Okay, what about the key genes controlling the cell cycle? In each cell, we have what's called proto-oncogenes and tumor suppressor genes. These are the key genes controlling the cell cycle. In the normal cell cycle, the proto-oncogene serves as the gas for the car. It is the fuel for the car, the fuel for the cell cycle to occur. While the tumor suppressor gene breaks the cell cycle to repair the mutations, okay? So there is normally a balance between the proto-oncogene and the tumor suppressor genes. Balance between the gas and the brakes. Mutations leading to cancer make the proto-oncogene is converted to oncogenes, okay? Leading to too much gas, too much cell cycle, too much growth. And the tumor suppressor genes get inactivated. So there will be no break for the cell cycle. So there will be imbalance between the gas and the brakes, the proto-oncogenes and the tumor suppressor genes. The proto-oncogenes are part of normal genome, which are coding for proteins that normally potentiate cell division, growth, and survival under physiological stimuli. They may code for growth factors, growth factor receptors, proteins involved in the intracellular signal transduction, cyclic dependent kinases or CDKs, apoptotic inhibitors, or transcriptional factors. So the proto-oncogenes, I will stress that it is part of normal genome and normally potentiate cell division. Okay? So the proto-oncogene, or what's called pre-oncogene, is or lead to normal regulated cell growth. When it has or it acquires gain of function mutation, it will be converted to what's called oncogene. And this oncogene will be converted into cancer. So here is a proto-oncogene like that. It may acquire a coding mutation. So this
Hello, Dr. Marwa.
The proto-oncogene is good while the oncogenes are bad. Tumor suppressor genes are part of normal genome as the proto-oncogenes, which normally inhibit cell division. So proto-oncogene lead to cell division, while tumor suppressor gene, which serve as the brakes for cell cycle, normally inhibit cell division. They are classified into two groups: gatekeeper tumor suppressor genes, and the products of these genes control the gates on the pathways of cell proliferation. So they are negative regulator of cell cycle, inhibit the cell cycle, while the Another classification is caretaker tumor suppressor gene, which is the function is not to control the speed of cell cycle, but rather it controls the accuracy. They are involved in DNA repair and in the control of genomic stability. For carcinogenesis, two copies of tumor suppressor gene must be affected. I told you that each chromosome has the same, its same copy in the same cell. So our genome has a copy, the genome has two copies in each cell. So tumor suppressor gene or proto-oncogene or any gene has two copies in the same cell. For any mutation or carcinogenesis to occur, the two copies or two alleles of the tumor suppressor genes or the gene must be affected. So if the one copy only is affected, this will not lead to carcinogenesis because the another copy will take the function. So here we have two copies of tumor suppressor gene. In the first hit in mutation in the tumor suppressor gene in one copy occurred. At this point, we are normal, no cancer. But if a second hit occurred, the chromosome will lose its wild type, leading to non-functional tumor suppressor. Okay? So in conclusion, tumor suppressor gene inhibits cell division, while the proto-oncogene stimulate cell division. Now, we reached the point of molecular pathogenesis of hematological malignancies. The molecular pathogenesis of hematological malignancy involves, number one, activation of oncogenes. Number two, inactivation of tumor suppressor genes. Number three, block of differences. As regards activation of oncogenes, involve genetic changes to cellular proto-oncogenes. Remember that proto-oncogenes is normal, and if an activating mutation occurs, it will be converted into oncogenes. Three genetic mechanisms activate oncogenes. These mechanisms are mutation, gene amplification, or chromosome rearrangement. The mutation we talked about, these mechanisms result in either an alteration of proto-oncogene structure or an increase in the proto-oncogene expression. These are the mechanisms represented in a picture. This is the normal gene. This normal gene may be amplified like that. And we have many copies, up to 100 copies of this gene. Okay, so there will be an excessive amount of protein product of this gene, or it may have a mutation leading to abnormal protein product, or it may have chromosome rearrangement. The chromosome rearrangement lead to whether novel regulatory sequences and novel protein product or fusion transcripts. What's meant by gene fusion? This is one of the chromosomal rearrangements. The first example of gene fusion was discovered through the cloning of the breakpoint of Philadelphia chromosome in CML or chronic myelogenous leukemia. There is translocation between chromosome 9 and chromosome 22, in which there is fusion in the CABL gene, normally located at chromosome number 9q34, with the BCR gene at chromosome 22q11. The BCR ABL fusion created on chromosome 22 encode a chimeric protein of 210 kDa, with increased tyrosine kinase activity and abnormal cellular localization. Like that, this is the BCR gene on chromosome 22, and this is the ABL gene on chromosome 9. There will be a breaking point here and the breaking point here, leading translocation of chromosome number 22 and 9, translocation 922, leading to a fusion gene, which is called BCR-ABL. When this gene is transcribed, there will be a fusion messenger RNA BCR-ABL, and it will be translated into a fusion protein product, which is called BCR-ABL. The second example of gene fusion is the common translocation between chromosome 15 and the chromosome 17, which is associated with expression of the PML RARA fusion protein in acute myeloid leukemia. This is the second mechanism of our second molecular pathogenesis of the hematological malignancy, which is inactivation of tumor suppressor gene, which must be biallelic in the two copies of the gene. The mechanisms may be deletion of the gene that code for the tumor suppressor protein, or frame shift mutation, or silencing of this tumor suppressor gene by alteration of the promoter region or the regulatory region, or point mutations that inhibit the activity of the corresponding protein. The third mechanism is a block of differentiation, and this is very complicated. So, but this is an example of acute promyelocytic leukemia cell, which has the abnormal fusion protein product, which is PML-RARA. Okay, this protein leads to a differentiation block. What's meant by differentiation block? Block of maturation of the cells, okay, and the block of the apoptosis, which is the programmed cell death of the abnormal cells. So leading to immature cells in acute myeloid leukemia or acute promyelocytic leukemia. Okay. In conclusion, the pathogenesis of hematological malignancies involves genomic instability with multiple steps of genetic or epigenetic alterations of either proto-oncogenes or tumor suppressor genes, leading to impaired control of cell cycle in one cell, leading to its rapid, uncontrolled proliferation with expansion of the growth over the expense of normal growth of other cells, and speed through or even escape the cell cycle checkpoints, passing the DNA mutations to the daughter cells. Also involve defects in the terminal differentiation of the cells and inhibition of apoptosis. Neoplasia is a multi-step process. More than one of these mechanisms often contribute to genesis of human tumors. يعني احنا, in one type of malignancy, we find many of the mechanisms that contribute to the genesis of this malignancy by altering number of cancer-associated genes. Full expression of neoplastic phenotype, including the capacity for metastasis, usually involve a combination of proto-oncogene activation and the tumor suppressor gene loss or inactivation. And thank you. Thank you.